an honor and a privilege to introduce today's plenary speaker, Frances E. Allen. Like many women of her generation, Fran Allen started out her career with a degree in education, in her case, from Albany State Teachers College back in 1957. She then went on to earn a master's degree in mathematics at the University of Michigan, and at that point, IBM had the good sense to recruit her to join their team. At IBM, Fran quickly became a pioneer in the field of compilers and also in high-performance computing. She is widely recognized for her fundamental work in the theory of program optimization and also for her early leadership of the Parallel Translations Project. Fran has won many significant awards for her work over the years. Among them, she is an IBM Fellow, which is an extremely prestigious award at IBM. And in 2007, the Association of Computing Machinery announced that Fran Allen was the recipient of the Turing Award, which is the highest honor for a computer science researcher in our field. And she is the first woman to win this award. Fran has also distinguished herself in service contributions to our community, and particularly in supporting women. She spent many years as a mentor through IBM's mentor program. In 2000, she herself became the first recipient of the Fran Allen Women in Technology Mentoring Award. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Fran Allen, our plenary speaker today.
I'm so delighted to be here, and I assume the slides will come up. I have so much to tell you. We've got a lot of work to do this morning. I'm going to make quite a few suggestions, and I'm going to tell you about my own career, and what is this?
To forward your slide in reverse.
Thanks. I need some technology help. Okay, I'm going to talk about really what it means to me, has meant to me, to win the Turing Award, a great deal, and also to comment on the fact that the times they are changing for computer science and for the whole impact that computing has had on our field and on every other field and on people around the world. So, as I said, we've got work to do this morning, so let's get with it if I get the technology worked out here. Next. Okay. So change is happening. And as everyone knows, last year I won the Turing Award, and I just thought I would point out that I am the first woman since the award was initiated by ACM in 1966, and there have been a total of 54 people have received it. Now, I am deeply honored by that, but also deeply concerned. And I think we all should be very deeply concerned that more of the women in our field are not receiving, in my opinion, the awards that they deserve. And anyway, before I get into my rants on some of that, and I don't, well, really, we'll try not to do a rant, I do want to talk about a number of things. There's a list of what I'm going to talk about, but I also want to we'll start. I'm going to, since Anne has given such a nice introduction about my background before I joined IBM, with how I joined IBM. IBM had a recruiting brochure. This in 1957, And I didn't see it at the time when I was recruited while at the University of Michigan finishing up my master's degree in mathematics, but I came across this quite a few years later, and I'm certain, or it's likely, that I was recruited as a result of IBM's expanding its needing many people at that time, and looking for women. It's always had a great history of hiring women, and then and other minorities, of course, going way back, and this was, I want to point out, well before computer science. When I computer science didn't exist when I started in 57, and it didn't come into existence until at least 10 years later. So, and I'm going to come back to that point at some stage. So, the first project after I joined IBM, since I'd been a high school math teacher for a while, and I joined as a programmer, my management decided that I should teach the new Fortran language, which had come out a few months before I joined, and they were going to issue an edict that everybody, all the scientists in IBM research, were going to have to use this language, and give up on using assembly language. Well, they had to take a course. And I was the teacher of the course, and I had to learn Fortran and teach this unhappy class of scientists how to use it. Well, the nut of it is that I was enamored with the whole idea of using a high-level language. Everybody and adopted, and I didn't realize I'd done it at the time, but over the years I realized I adopted the goals that John Backus had set in establishing Fortran for user productivity and problem performance. And so that became the goals of my entire career in high-performance computing and in compilers and computer languages for high-performance computing.